Minister, this question just is kind of related to the previous question in relation to workers within the offshore industry, but it relates to the provision of work boats to service the construction of offshore wind developments, where there is potential for substantial work for Irish boatyards in building and supplying the work boats necessary for any future developments.
The regulations which govern maritime safety issues are complex and varied and depend on many issues such as the type of the vessel, its size, its proposed operating area and other factors. I am unclear as to the particular thrust of the Deputy's question, and I'm sure you'll clarify that in the supplementary, Deputy, but I can confirm that Ireland applies the internationally recognised standards to vessels servicing the offshore renewable sector, that the standard of the IMO's conventions governing such vessels and the relevant European regulations in relation to this area are applied. In the main, the relevant conventions are the IMO SULAS Convention, International Load Line Convention, and the EU Passenger Ship Directive 2009/45. In cases relating to vessels carrying less than 12 passengers, then domestic legislation does apply, for example, statutory instruments. Subject to compliance with the relevant conventions and regulations I've just referred to, there are no restrictions applying to Irish boatyards in relation to the supply of vessels for the offshore wind farm sector. In the case of vessels flying the Irish flag, my department, which acts as the safety regulator for the maritime sector, has arrangements in place for the surveying of vessels. The larger vessels will be surveyed by a recognised organisation, or in the case of smaller vessels, the department itself will undertake the work. Vessels meeting the required standards will be issued with the relevant convention certificates appropriate to the type of vessel in question. Similarly, a foreign flagged vessel in Ireland will need to comply with international conventions and the Irish regulations as appropriate to their intended operations.
Thank you. Deputy.
Minister, as I understand the situation, vessels built in Ireland for working in Irish waters cannot move out and work in other waters. And similarly, vessels operating in other waters within Europe cannot come to Ireland to work without substantial alteration and modification as well. So this place hampers Irish boatyards in being able to provide vessels that can work right across Europe and being able to avail of the offshore opportunities in the Irish sector as well. So I think it's similar to the training issue for staff. I think it's something that should be looked at again within the department to ensure that Irish boatyards will be in a position to avail of this. I understand that there could be, if developments take place in the Irish Sea, there could be up to 40 vessels required very quickly in order to provide for those, and then after the construction period there will be an ongoing requirement for vessels to carry out maintenance as well. So I think there is an opportunity there, and it's an opportunity that we should be gearing up to avail of ourselves.
Thank you, Deputy. I think in relation to this particular point that the next step in relation to this, Deputy, is the same as your priority question, which is that you evidently have groups or constituents who have considerable expertise in this area and believe there is an opportunity there in the future. And if they have ideas or input regarding how Ireland could best take advantage of this, I'm very open to hearing them, because as you have said yourself, this is an important part of our offshore economy, but it is one that is growing and it's one that is likely to grow elsewhere. And the Irish maritime sector should be well placed to take advantage of that. The one point I'd want to clarify in relation to the application of regulation is the key thing, Deputy, as I'm sure you're aware, is where the ship is flagged. So if they are flagged with us, then they have to comply to regulations in relation to maritime safety and so on. And all of the regulations that we have laid down in that area are ones that are recognised by the international marine organisations and by the European Union to give ships that are flagged under the Irish flag the best opportunities in our own shores and abroad.